Maps were once a symbol of adventure and exploration, but now they're just used for directions.
Turn left, left, left.
What if maps could do more, like take on one of the world's biggest problems, climate change?
The Amazon is a massive machine that pumps carbon from the atmosphere. The Amazon alone could be capturing about 600 million tons CO2 equivalent per year.
But the Amazon is in a delicate place, and in the first half of this year, it lost an area that's 5 times the size of New York City. Because of fires, illegal deforestation, mining, and other land uses, the Amazon is inching closer to a point of no return.
If we take out the Amazon from the globe, it's like no way we can get to the Paris Agreement. We have this tragedy where the interests of very few people is creating a problem for everybody else.
This group of scientists and NGOs are using satellite imagery to track how the Amazon is changing and report illegal activity to authorities in Brazil.
This is a paradigm shift that we are seeking. Right now, impunity prevails, but we have to change that.
What MapBiomas is doing is to understand what we are doing to the planet so we can care.
Now we understand the potential of the technology. We have to change this future.
The main threat to the Amazon is by far deforestation. Now we have about 20% of the Amazon has been clear-cut. From all the area that has been clear-cut since 85 to 2020, we find out that 74% today are pastureland.
Brazil is one of the largest exporters of beef in the world. And as of 2021, that's a $9 billion market.
The Amazon now is being changed to pasturelands. It creates a completely different type of environment that eventually may make the Amazon region to collapse as an ecosystem that we know. MapBiomas helps to understand the negative impact of land use in Brazil. The initial goal when MapBiomas was created was to fill the gap of information.
Before MapBiomas, maps of Brazil were provided by the government and took years to make. So the maps that were available to the public were outdated.
So we put this question, how can we do annual maps going backwards as far as we can?
In addition to tracking deforestation, MapBiomas has developed products that can map land impacted by fires, how and where surface water is receding, even soil health and biodiversity.
What we do actually is we break down Brazil in 9.6 billion pixels. Each one has 30 by 30 meters. And each one of those squares, our challenge is to tell what is that.
Using Google Earth Engine, MapBiomas has a set of algorithms which identify whether a pixel is agriculture, water, or pasture, along with 22 other classifications. These pixels are then analyzed by a network of scientists and experts at MapBiomas.
MapBiomas brings together technology and people. I mean, if you just have the technology or just have the people, things will not work. People with different expertise is what allow us to use, in a creative way, the technologies that are available. Mesmo aqui são os alertas que foram consolidados por Bioma. MapBiomas Alert is an initiative that was done on demand by people that were using information on deforestation in Brazil.
Basically, what we do is we validate all deforestation alerts in Brazil in high-resolution images, and after they are validated, they are published in one single open and public platform.
Todos os dados gerados pelo MapBiomas Alerta são disponibilizados de forma aberta para o público. E relatórios customizados são produzidos de forma automática para diferentes órgãos públicos, permitindo monitoramento de atividades legais e autorizadas e o combate ao desmatamento ilegal.
You have an image before and after, which makes it very clear where you have the deforestation in the last 3 years. 98.9% of the deforestation in the Amazon has at least one evidence of illegality. We have to push the boundaries to guarantee that all the reports will have a consequence.
The MapBiomas alert system is used by 168 institutions, including environmental agencies, banks, traders, and consumers, to avoid doing business with an illegally deforested site. It's also used by the federal prosecutor's office to turn alerts into action. So far, they've filed more than 4,500 environmental cases using MapBiomas' data.
O Amazonas Protege é projeto novo do Ministério Público Federal em que ele busca justamente punir os infratores sem a necessidade de ir a campo.
It's very dangerous to do ground verification of illegal deforestation. People can get hurt. The vehicles can be apprehended, destroyed, burned. Even helicopters had been shot with guns. So satellite imagery reduces this risk.
Quando nós temos sistema que depende da ida a campo, a maioria das pessoas não vão ser visitadas, não vão ser punidas. Quando, por outro lado, a gente consegue usar a imagem de satélite e punir todo mundo...
Satellite data, it's transparent, it reduces the cost, and it can speed up the process to enforce the law. The most significant impact that MapBiomas can have in the short term is to put this electronic law enforcement system in place in Brazil.
We just want this to be actionable, to actually manage better the natural environment. There is tons of applications. It goes all the way from monitoring indigenous lands to the relationship between gold mining and the contamination of the water. These are examples of how this is being used. The way we do it is that we make it as open as possible. All data, everything that is produced by MapBiomas is available on the internet to anyone to use.
The work isn't contained to Brazil. MapBiomas works with a network of local organizations around the world to expand its impact.
MapBiomas is now on 14 countries, which includes all countries in South America plus Indonesia. It's really shared science for everyone. I think if something like MapBiomas was spread out all over the planet, we will have a much better understanding of the dynamics of how the land is changing and thus allowing us to take better decisions to sustainably manage our natural resources. If there is one of the largest economies in the world that could actually neutralize its emission, it's Brazil. So that's the difference between protecting the Amazon and not protecting the Amazon. If we can unlock this potential and use this potential, Brazil could be the leadership, the example of how can we actually treat better our natural resources and by doing that, fighting climate change.